Now we are going to start with the cost function in logistic regression, and we will also see gradient descent in logistic regression. So earlier in the previous tutorial, we have come up with a hypothesis function in case of logistic regression, which was equal to 1 upon 1 plus e raised to the power minus theta transpose x. So we have come up with this hypothesis function, and we know that this actually comes from a logistic function. And now we are going to find out the theta parameters, because that's the only thing that we need to find out to get this hypothesis function. If we will get this hypothesis function, we will be able to get a curve which can best fit my data set. So now we know that if we want to find out the theta parameters, we first have to find out the cost. We have to find the cost when we are choosing some certain theta parameters. For example, if I chose a theta parameter as, let's say, some variable 7. If you will go here, you can see that this is just a website, desmos.com. So you can actually write the function and it will give you the corresponding curve here. So you can see I have written the function of the logistic regression. Now instead of theta, you can see I have written minus x. So this means the theta parameter is 1 in this case. Now if I will change this theta parameter to 2, just observe the change in the graph. You can see now the graph is shrinking. If I will change it to a bigger value, let's say 26, you can see it will shrink more. So now you can see that if we are choosing different parameters, we will get different types of curves. Now what we have to do is we have to find out the cost with each of the curve, with respect to each of the curve, and then we can actually run the gradient descent algorithm to find out the minimum cost. And in that way, if we will find the minimum cost, we will find the theta parameters corresponding to it. And then we will be successful in getting a graph which will be able to best fit my data set. So now we're going to discuss the cost function. Now, the cost function that we're going to use in this tutorial in the logistic regression is quite different from the cost function that we discussed in the linear regression. So I'm going to ask you a question. Can you use the cost function of linear regression to find out the cost of this hypothesis function? Then the answer is no. The answer is no, because if you will try to use the cost function of linear regression on this hypothesis function, it is generally observed that you are going to get a curve which will be a wavy type of curve, something like this. Now the problem with this type of curve, now this curve is corresponding to the cost function. So if you will use the cost function of the linear regression and you will apply it on this hypothesis, you will get a curve corresponding to this one. Now you can see that if you will try to run the gradient descent algorithm, let's say that you chose a point from here and the gradient descent algorithm is starting to go down. So it will reach a minima here. Now this minima is the local minima. And you can see that we have a minima here, which is supposed to be the most minimum point if you will observe here. And we need this point as an answer. We don't need this point. So gradient descent algorithm will get a problem here because of the local minimas. So we cannot use, I'm going to write here an important point, we cannot use linear regression cost function. And the reason is that we will get the curve of the cost function will be a wavy curve producing many local minimas. So we have to come up with a cost function which we can use for the logistic regression, which will not create this wavy curve. It will create a curve which will have only one minima, which is also known as the global minima. Right, we have to find a cost function. So the cost function, which is j of theta, is in case of logistic regression, it is equals to 1 divided by m. Sigma goes from I equals to 1 till all the training examples. And inside, I'm going to find out the cost of h theta x ith example, comma y ith example. Now you can see the difference is that I am not using 1 upon 2m. That's the first difference, and we are not calculating the square. So what we need to do is we will find out the cost of the h theta x I y I, and we will get a curve which will not be a wavy curve. So now you can see that we have a logistic regression, which is basically a classification problem. So if you will observe this graph here, this one, you can see that the y can have two values. Y can be equal to 0 or y can be equal to 1. So if y equals to 0, then we will have a different cost, and when y equals to 1, we have a different cost. So what we're going to do is we are going to write two cases, y equals to 0 and when y equals to 1, because for these two cases, the cost that we are going to assign will be different. So when y equals to 0, I'm going to assign the cost of h theta of x comma y is equals to minus log 1 minus h theta of x, like this. And in case of y equals to 1, the cost function will be minus log of h theta x. Now you might get confused that why are we actually using these two cost in these two cases. So the confusion will get solved when we will try to plot the cost function in these two cases, and we will see what the graph will look like. So if y equals to 1, and if I will try to plot the j theta versus the hypothesis function graph, so if I will try to plot the graph, now it is observed that when y equals to 0 and I am using this cost, you will get a curve which will go something like this. It will meet the x-axis at the position 1, and it will never meet the y-axis. So this is the x-axis represents hx, and this represents the cost function. So when y equals to 0, and if you will try to plot this graph, the graph corresponding to this one, you will get a curve something like this. And if y equals to 0, sorry, now y equals to 1, we are going to find out what is the graph that will correspond to h theta, hx, and j theta. So it is observed that if you will try to plot the graph corresponding to this one, which is when y equals to 1, you will get a graph which goes from 0, it touches the x-axis at 0, and it goes something like this. Now it will never meet when x, the value of x, is equals to 1. So at 1 it will go till infinitive. So I'll write hx and j, or the cost function here. So this is the graph that we will get of the cost function when these are the two cases. If we will combine these two cases, if we will try to combine these two graphs, we will get a graph which will be something like this, like a parabola. Now the speciality about this graph is that it has only one minima, which we can call as the global minima. Now you can see that it is in contrast with this graph, which will give me some local minimas. So now I can run the gradient descent algorithm to find out this local minima, and then I will find out the theta parameters at this point, which I will put in the hypothesis function, and it will basically give me the curve corresponding to it. Alright, so instead of having these two cases, y equals to 0, y equals to 1, we can actually combine both of these in a single equation. Now observe this equation very carefully. Cost of h theta x comma y. I'm going to combine both of these. So I will say minus y log of h theta x. And I'm going to write minus 1 minus y, 1 minus h theta of x. Something like this. So you can see that if we will put y equals to 0, if we will put y equals to 0 in this equation, it will make this whole term, this term as 0, y will be equal to 0. So it will actually give me minus 1 plus h theta of x, right? So it will give me this minus log 1 minus h theta of x. All right, so here it should not be this one, it should be 1 minus y log of 1 minus h theta x. All right, so that was a mistake. So now if you will put y equals to 0, this term will become 0. And y will be equal to what? 0. So minus 1 log of 1 minus h theta x. This is actually this one. If you will put y equals to 1, you will get minus log h theta x. You can try it. So now what I can do is, you can see I have got a single equation that can represent these two cases. So if I will plot the cost function of this graph, I will get a graph something like this, like a parabola. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to this is the way I have simplified. This is a simplified version of the cost function. And now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to finalize the cost function of logistic regression by putting this in this whole equation inside this one. I will just place it here. And then I will find, then this will be my cost function. So the final, our finalized version of cost function will be 1 upon m sigma goes from I equals to 1 till m. And inside I will put this equation minus y log of h theta x minus 1 minus y log of 1 minus h theta x. So this is going to be my final cost function equation, which I'm going to actually use, and it will give me a graph which will be something like this. So let's see how we can run the gradient descent algorithm. Now let's move on to the gradient descent. So now there is a very good thing about gradient descent, that this algorithm is independent of what hypothesis function you're using. That's a fortunate thing about gradient descent. So I'm going to ask you a question, that can you use the gradient descent algorithm that we have used in the linear regression in this case also? So now the answer is yes here, because the gradient descent algorithm is basically an algorithm. What it tries to do is, it tries to update the values of theta with some alpha learning rate, and it will always try to repeat itself until it converges, and it will be able to find out this minima point here. So the answer is that gradient descent algorithm will not be different in the case of logistic regression. It will be same as linear regression. It will be same as linear regression. And one important point here about cos function is that this function is a convex function, right? So convex function will give you a global minima, something like this. Now gradient descent is same as linear regression, so we already know how the algorithm of gradient descent works. If you don't know about gradient descent in linear regression, you can check out the video where we have discussed about linear regression. Well, the algorithm is repeat until convergence, and what we are going to do is we are going to update the values of theta parameters using this update symbol, and it will be again same as the previous one. Instead of 2m, I will write m here, I equals to 1 till m h theta xi minus yi into x I and j. So this is going to be my gradient descent algorithm. Nothing has changed here, and this algorithm will run and it will be able to find the global minima. It will be able to find this global minima, and then what we will do is we will find out the theta parameters at this position. We will place it inside of this hx function, and we will get a graph which will try to best fit our data points. If you will put these theta parameters in the equation that we have used here, you can see I have used a linear regression equation. So if you will put these theta parameters in the hypothesis function of a linear regression, which is theta transpose x. So if you will place the theta parameters that you have seen, you have come up with using the gradient descent algorithm from here, if you will put it here, you're basically going to get a line that will be able to separate out our two classes. This is going to be the line. Now this line is known as decision boundary because it can help us decide which class is a particular point belonging to. So that's all for this tutorial. In the upcoming tutorials, we are going to see some of the important points, some of the important concepts, which is the problem of overfitting. And we will also understand some concepts which can resolve this problem using regularization. So in the next tutorial, we will start with the problem of overfitting. That's all for this tutorial. Thanks for watching.